Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Thanks so much for stopping by. I know I've been a little MIA, but I've been kind of torn between a lot of things lately, so I really want to spend some time and put it back into my channel and do as many videos as I can, and yeah, all that good stuff. So today I'm going to be doing this like orangey inspired, like not March makeup. I literally hate this time of the year. I know it's the beginning of the year, it's like that hump once I get over January and I'm like new year, new me. Once I get into March, I'm kind of like, oh my god, I just want it to be spring slash summer. So because the weather isn't cooperating, I'm going to just put my makeup there and just kind of push brighter coral citrusy colors back into my everyday routine and into my wardrobe, just to kind of get some color to my life, dude. Anyway, so today I'm gonna be doing this look. It's super simple. I use the Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette, which is an amazing palette. If you're just, you know, interested in getting a palette that would have like all these neutral colors in it, I definitely recommend picking this guy up. It smells amazing. It smells like chocolate. I know some people don't like that, but I think it's a huge plus to the palette, but it looks like this, and the colors are gorgeous. It has so many staple eyeshadows in it, but from matte colors to kind of more shimmery shadows. It's a really, really great collection of eyeshadows, and I highly recommend it by Too Faced. I think they knocked that palette out of the park. Yeah, so that's pretty much it. I will link everything that I use in this video down below. Subscribe, like it, and I will see you guys on the other side. Bye. So I already went in with my MAC Prep and Prime. This is the natural radiance base Lumiere, which I love. I use it in pretty much like every video. And then I went ahead and did my brows, girl, because my brows were looking crazy. And I did my brows with the Anastasia Beverly Hills brow wiz pencil, which I love. So now I'm gonna go in, and the first thing I'm gonna do is start to color correct. I look so tired. I always just blame it on being tired, but really I just have Indian jeans. Yeah, I'm just never gonna get rid of these under eye circles, but whatever. I'm gonna go in with my LA Girl Pro Conceal. This is the orange concealer from their line, and I've used this in like the past couple of videos. I love this stuff. So it's the same deal, just placing the product down with my finger. And then I'm going to go in with my beauty blender and just kind of diffuse that color out a little bit, because it gets a little crazy. Otherwise, when you start blending out your concealer, you're gonna get like this weird orange tint to your stuff, and it's gonna look nuts. So I'm gonna take this, and I'm gonna actually take it above too. Now that that's done, I'm gonna go in with my beauty blender, and it's damp. Always use your beauty blender damp, and I'm just gonna start diffusing this color out, because we don't want this peeking through. Ain't nobody got time for that. Now that that's done, I'm gonna go in with my Becca Ultimate Coverage Complexion Cream. I wear the color Cafe, girl. And I'm going to take this on the back of my hand like this. I usually do like a pump and a half. I actually really love the pump on this thing, because it allows me to pick up just enough product. I hate, like, MAC is notorious for that, like having pumps that just like don't let you control how much product you're taking out. That drives me crazy. So I'm just gonna go and start buffing this on my face. My hoops are getting in the way. This stuff is amazing. Or definitely check out Becca, because I feel like they have really done us brown girls some justice. I'm just gonna bring that down on my neck. Now that that's on, I'm gonna go in with my concealer now. I'm using the It Cosmetics Bye Bye Under Eye. This stuff is amazing. I got it in my my Ipsy package. It is so good. So it's really important when using this concealer to warm it up on your hand like this. Like, don't just dab it and put it on your face. Because the consistency is like super thick, so you really want it to like get nice and creamy before you start placing it. And I'm just going to use my finger, and I'm going to tap this in place, and then go in with my beauty blender after and blend this bad boy. So I'm going to tap it like that and then bring it a little down. And I'm actually gonna take a little bit just to cheat a little bit and get a reverse contour going, I'm just gonna take a little bit and put it right here on the inside of my nose. And then I'm gonna go in with a beauty blender, like I said, and then just buff it out. You don't have to worry about putting too much product down when you're like just patting this on, because your beauty blender is gonna pick up any product that's like extra, you know? So now I'm gonna go in with a cream contour. I'm gonna be using the NYX HD Concealer. This is like way darker than my skin tone though, and I'm gonna use it to conceal, and this is in the color Nutmeg. I said Nutmeg. Girl, I can't read. So I'm gonna take it, and this was like $3.99. So then I'm just gonna go blend this out with my beauty blender. Blend, 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 blend. It's the name of the game. It's the name of the makeup game. Just gonna blend it out. So now that that's nice and set, I'm taking a tan. Yo, I really am like craving going to beach. I've been dreaming about it like the past couple nights. Like I'm like, I really want to go to a beach. So because I'm in New York and it's 35 degrees out today, I'm going to fake it with my contour. So now I'm going to go in with my Nye Banana Powder. You guys know I love this stuff. It's amazing. I'm going to pick it up with my beauty blender and place it right underneath my under eyes to kind of set that It Cosmetics concealer that we put on. And I'm going to lightly bake, and by that I mean I'm going to place excess on it and then I'm just gonna wipe away. I'm not gonna wait for it to fully settle in there because ain't nobody got time for that. And I'm going to take just like ever so slightly on the tip of the beauty blender, just like take it down the shaft of my nose. This is like a flat eyeshadow brush. I used this in the past couple videos, and I'm just going to literally pat in the powder and then wipe away the excess, if that makes sense. So you're really just setting that powder that you used before, but you're kind of like molding it, I guess, melting. You're melting the powder into the cream, which gives it such a nice effect. And then I'm gonna take a little bit of my Makeup Forever HD High Definition Powder. Another like cult favorite, love this stuff. So I'm just going to work this on the other areas. I'm not putting too much on though. Honestly, just like ever so slightly, just cause we use so many cream products. I just wanna make sure, you know, nothing moves around. So now for eyes, I'm gonna go in with A Bombshell Cosmetics Eye Base in the color Submissive. I've used this a lot in my videos. This is like a go-to favorite of mine, and I just go in with my pointer finger, and I'm gonna put this all over my eyelids just to act as a shimmery base for the eyes. Okay, so I went ahead and did one eye off camera, which is why I look crazy, but I'm gonna go in and do the other eye. So today I'm using the Too Faced Chocolate Bar Palette. This thing is amazing for like everyday, like if you travel a lot and you're looking for one palette to hold all the shadows that you can do all these different types of looks with, whether it's like a daytime look transitioning into night, I highly recommend this palette. I know it smells like chocolate and a lot of people don't like that, but that's like one of the reasons why I do love it. So I'm gonna go in with this peachy color right here, and I'm gonna take this on my, this is like a MAC 217, so it's just like a fluffy blending brush. And I'm gonna pick up this product and I'm gonna go all over my eyelid with it. This is like a really gorgeous like peachy color, which is amazing for darker skin tones. I feel like a lot of people don't use like the peachy colors, but I think that they're amazing. They work really, really well with this skin tone. So definitely don't sleep on the peachy ones. I so now I'm gonna go in with this Smudge Tosh. Girl, I don't know. Beam Cash. Yo, this is a French name, so let me just not attempt it. So now I'm gonna go in with this like medium darker color, and I'm gonna work this into my crease. I'm gonna pick up some color and work this into my crease and just start like ever so slightly, not pressing all the way in. I'm just gonna start working this like right through the crease. So now I'm gonna go in with my MAC. I wanna say this is my 209, my MAC 209 brush. And I'm gonna pick up this color right here, this gold color. I'm gonna pick this up and run it like right through. I'm just gonna press it. I'm not gonna kind of smudge it out a little bit, but I'm just gonna press it right on top of my lids. So, like this. Next, I'm gonna go back in with my 217, pick up some of that brown again, and just kind of make sure this is all blended out. This isn't like a very difficult eyeshadow look, but you just want to make sure everything is blended so it's kind of like nicely smoked, you know? Then I'm gonna go in with this little guy right here. I love these brushes. This is a detailer brush from Real Techniques. I take this this brush and pick up this darker color up here, and I love this for kind of like getting into like right above your upper lash line, just to try to get like that nice little like smoked out line without having it be too thick or too thin and not being able to see it at all. Am I making sense? I'm gonna just show you. Gonna take a little bit into this little corner of my eye, just to kind of get it like really, really nicely smoked. Almost that when you close your eyes, once I smoke this out, obviously, you're gonna see like a little outline of like the gold. So now I'm gonna go in with this Jouer eye definer. This is in the color, it's spelled Gris, but I know this is French, so it's gonna be like Gris. But this is like a really gorgeous, like deep forest green color. And I know you guys are probably thinking like forest green. It doesn't look as harsh and like as ashy as like the blacker eyeliners that people tend to use in these types of looks. So I've been using it a lot actually recently. I'm just gonna run a thin line of this above my upper lash line and just kind of go over the powder that we just put on. And then I'm gonna also work it into my lower waterline as well, all the way to the inner corner. Now I'm gonna go into my Bellamy eyeliner. I'm gonna link it down below because I've completely like wiped off anything. I'm going to just tight line the upper lash line. Now I'm gonna go back in with a fluffy blending brush, and I'm going to start building a little bit of color underneath my lower lash line. So I'm going to take this color right here and just run it right underneath my lower lash line. Gonna give a little bit more dimension. It's not gonna look as harsh when we put mascara on. Y'all know what I'm gonna do now. I'm gonna curl these bad boys. Going with my Shoe Emora eyelash curler. I've been really into like warmer colors, like this guy, like this orange, my color of my nails, reds. I don't know, I'm just like loving those types of colors, which is so different for me because when I was younger, I loved like turquoise and green and like blues and all those types of colors. But now I'm like, now that I'm older, I'm really into like oranges and reds and very citrus oriented colors. So now that those are curled, I'm gonna go in with my Smashbox Full Exposure mascara. If you're looking for a new mascara, definitely give this one a try. I'm gonna skip the falsies today because I'm just not in the mood for falsies today. So So now I'm gonna go in with NARS blush, and this is in the color Liberté. And this is like a gorgeous color. Love, love, love this stuff. And I'm gonna work this onto the apples of my cheeks. So just smiling and, you know, profiling. Now that that's done, I'm gonna go in with my ColourPop luminizer in the color Wisp. This is a Super Shock Cheek Pearlized formula, and it's gorgeous. It looks like this. I'm a big fan of ColourPop just because A, their price point is like unbeatable, but also their formulas are amazing. So if you haven't tried ColourPop, definitely check them out. They always have like great online deals. And I ordered a bunch of stuff off there and I was not disappointed with anything that I bought. So I'll do a review of the products that I bought if anybody's interested. But yeah, they're amazing and really, really well priced. So I'm just gonna place this. I'm gonna run it lightly for my highlight with my finger. That is the one thing I will say though about ColourPop. Their products are best applied with your hands, your digits, and not brushes because they're so like creamy cake consistency. Want to get that glow, you know? Then I'm gonna take a little bit and work it onto the tip of my nose. And kind of up. And then I'm going to take a little bit and run it right underneath my eyebrows, like right here. And that's just gonna tie like the entire glow together, kind of pull the whole look together. So. I'm also, because I feel like going back and doing this, because I think it looks really nice, I actually did it on the other eye too. I'm going to take a little bit of my Jouer liner and just do like a slight, ever so slight wing. You can't really see it there, it's like almost smoked out, but I just kind of like that effect and I think it elongates my eyes. So for lips, like I said, I've been loving the oranges, reds lately, like that's all I've been, you know, grabbing for when I'm doing my makeup. Maybe it's because it's March and I want it to be August. I don't know. But this is the MAC Pro Longwear Lip Pencil in What a Blast, and this is like straight up orange. And I'm not gonna like lip line my entire lip because this is really, really strong, but I'm going to just kind of like place a little bit of color down and then just like diffuse it with my finger because otherwise I'm gonna be looking real bright today. Now I'm gonna go in with my MAC lipstick in Vegas Volt. This is like very peachy orangey. And again, I'm not gonna like just completely fill in my lips, but I'm just going to place a little bit of color down just to kind of get it there. Just to kind of take it there. And then to gloss it up, because you guys know I love a good gloss, I'm gonna go in with my Jouer gloss in, let's see, Coral Glisten. And I love how small it is because this is like perfect for taking in your purse or anything like that. And that's it. That is the final look. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. The next video I'm going to be doing is a requested video, which is like, I know, not a big deal for other YouTubers, but because my channel is so young, a request is like everything to me. But yeah, I got a request to do a drugstore foundation review, and I picked up a great foundation, so I'm going to be doing a review in my next video, and I will get that to you guys like ASAP Rocky. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this look. I will link everything that I use down below. Follow me, subscribe to my channel, like this video up, thumb it up, and yeah, leave any comments down below. And yeah, I love interacting with you guys. So follow me on Twitter, follow me on Instagram, subscribe to my channel, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye. Okay. Deep breath, deep breath, deep breath. Enunciate, enunciate. I have a hard time enunciating my words. Oh my God, that's so good. Like dark ass color. Excuse my language. I'm gonna pick up this dark color. Oh my god. I'm filming outside of my window and my neighbors are walking with their dogs and they're probably like, what is this girl doing? At least my face is set though.
But, so I am not going to kiss.